Hi, today we are going to see some important SQLs in Oracle, which we are going to use in our day-to-day activities, that is support activities, okay? First query, we are going to see how to get the current schema name, okay? How to get the current schema name? By using the SQL, select six contexts. By passing the user environment and the current schema, we will get the schema name, that is the current user. Here, schema and user are one and the same in the Oracle, okay? Just execute this query. Already I have typed that query, which will give the current user name, that is demo. It is the current schema name, okay? Now, we are going to see how to get the DDL statement for any table. We have created the table, but we can see the description of the table. That means what are all the columns, what are all the data types, we can see by using the DESC. Thus, if you want to see the DDL statement, that is the data definition language, create table statement. If you want to see that, you cannot do it directly, okay? You have to use the utility package that is available in the Oracle, that is dbms metadata.getddl. By using that, you can get the required DDL. This query, I have written the query already. This query can be generalized to get the DDL statement of any database object. The query is select dbms underscore metadata dot get ddl, and we have to pass the table and table name and the username. Here, instead of table, if you want to get the view details, then you can pass the view name and username. Now we will see the query. See, I executed query. Already I have written that query. dbms underscore metadata dot get ddl. Then you have to pass table, then table name, then username from doer. It will give the DDL. That is the create statement. Okay. You can expand it and you can see the full. Create table, table name, locations, and the details of the column name, okay? See, here you can see that, full details, okay? This is the way you can get the DDL of the table, any table you can get. And now we are going to see another important SQL, that is how to find the last record from the table. This one is straightforward one. Using this, when your table does not have the primary key, or you cannot be sure if record having maximum primary key is the latest one. Okay. This is by using the maximum row ID, we can easily find out. I will show you now. Here I have written the query, select star from EMP where row ID is equal to select maximum of row ID from EMP. I have already put one video for that row ID and row number. Already I have got one video. You can see that video to know about what is row ID and row number. Okay. We have to get the maximum row ID from the EMP. Okay. Select star from EMP. Where OID is equal to select maximum of OID from EMP for the last record in the table. See, this is the last record in the table. for our verification, let me will check the EMP table. See, this is the last record. 7934 Miller is the last record. We have got that only 7934 Miller clerk. So it works fine. Then here we are going to find the size of the schema or user. If our size grows regularly, at least once in a week or one fortnight, we have to check the size of the schema. How can we do that? But we have got one query and we need to query the DBA segments. And for converting into MB, we need to divide it by 1024 and again by 1024, which is, these are all simple only, but which we will be using in our daily day-to-day support activities. See, it shows the size. It's very small only. As this learning environment, we are not going to have a very big data. But in the real-time environment, it will be very useful. And you can see the growth of your the database size. That means your schema size. Sorry. And to find out the latest database version, this is the last one. So far, we have seen 5 SQLs. This is the last one. Let's start from V$ version. It shows the version of the database. That is Oracle database 11G edition release 11.2. This is the information we have got by using the SQL select star from V$ version. Okay. Thanks. Bye. We will see some more SQLs like this in the next video.